we are going to do this task. Yeah, relax. No grammar to do. Okay? And the second chapter of this task. Right? And what's the name? The name is Tiger King and the author is Kalki. The author, this is Kalki, is his pen name. Right? And he is, his original name is Ramaswamy Iyer Krishnamurti. That's the original name of the writer or the author, and his pen name is Kalki. Now, what is the story about? The lesson is a sort of a satire. Okay? So what is the satire? Satire is that we talk about some behavior. Okay? Or I've written here some bad behavior or of a wrong thing in a comical manner or in a sarcastic manner. Okay? To gain the attention of the readers. So that's what we are going to talk about, or that writer has tried to tell about. He's talking about the odd things of the powerful ones. Okay? The odd behavior, their stubbornness, their pride, everything. But how? In a polished manner. Okay? And let's start with the story. Then things will be more clear. So this is what we are going to talk about. Now, as the story starts, okay, second chapter, mostly I'll be going line by line explanation. Now, before I read, just see the introduction, not exactly introduction, the first line in italics. What is the general attitude of human beings towards wild animals? This chapter, the name itself is Tiger King. So, initially when you came across the chapter or the name might be, you must have thought that king is as it is considered the king, or tiger, sorry, is as it is considered the king, or is it tiger? No, lion. Lion is considered as the king of the jungle. Okay, tiger also is powerful one, and might be we are going to talk about some tiger. But here it's not so. The writer is talking about the powerful people. It is the British period, and during the British rule, okay, so many kings were there, but they were ruling different states and different places, but the main power was in the British hands. And so it is telling that different kingdoms were ruled by different kings, but who was the sole authority? The Britishers. And here, that is why he is trying to, the writer has given statement, it's a questionnaire sort of, that what is the attitude, he's asking us, what is our opinion, okay, that what is the attitude of human beings towards whom? Towards the wild animals. Now let's move with the main section. The Maharaja of Pratibhapuram, that's the place, okay, and is the hero of the story. Hero means main character. Who is the, around whom is the story centered around? The story is centered around the Maharaja of Pratibhapuram. Okay, and here few titles are there because we are told he is very powerful. So, he is being designated by so many titles as we find here. What are they? Highness, then Jamedar, General, Kiledar, Major, Seta, Vyagra, Samhari, then Maharaja Dhiraj, Vishwa, Bhuvana, Samrat, Sir Jilani, Jung Jung Bahadur, MA8, ACTC, all CRCC. This might be all titles given to the whom? To this Maharaja. And but this name is often shortened to the Tiger King. So many titles he has got, but then this name, to emphasize his greatness, how is he known as? The Tiger King. So, Tiger King is not the tiger we are going to talk about. I hope you are clear. It's about the Maharaja Jailani Jung Jung Bahadur. Now, what is the writer trying to say? The writer is saying, I have come forward to tell you why he came to be known as Tiger King. Who? The person, that is the king, Jung Jung Bahadur. I have no intention of pretending to advance, only to end in a strategic withdrawal. He is saying that he is not trying to stay, or he is not going to step back. He because he is a king and he will not talk about, he must have started the story in other way, and seeing the pride or the stubbornness of the king might be his step back. He is saying that he will not withdraw from the intention that he is going to talk about this king. Okay, he will stick to it and he will let the readers know about the king. Sukta Bombar will not throw me off track. He is saying he is not scared about even the Sukta Bombar. What is Sukta Bombar? It's a German aircraft. Okay, and that is why it is said that even this Sukta Bombar also threatens him. He will not be stepping back. And at the same time, he is telling that sometimes it happens that Sukta Bombar also comes and without it goes away from the field without coming in action. But here, neither this writer Kalki will not do. Right at the start, it was imperative to disclose a matter of vital importance about the tiger. Everyone who reads of him will experience the natural desire to meet a man of his indomitable courage. What is indomitable? The something that cannot be beaten. So he is saying that as soon as people come to know about this man, this king, everyone would be interested to know. But he is saying right at the start, it is imperative to disclose a matter of vital importance. Saying before I talk about the king, something is more important for you to know. That is, I will tell them. Even if he is saying that, and desire courage face to face. He is saying indomitable courage face to face. Even though the king is powerful, we will talk about the man. But there is no chance of its fulfillment. He is saying that it would happen that he has the power and so on, the king. So might be they will step back and things. But there is no such chance after that anyone would get against or the writer would stop. As Bharata said to Rama about Dasharatha, the tiger king has reached that final abode of all living creatures. In other words, the tiger king is dead. Saying that initially when everyone, the reader is interested in knowing about the king and so, okay, he is saying that he has to give a brief description about that. And what is he saying? That you will feel, I know everyone would have a desire to meet the king, to be the king, but he is telling that I will tell you the fact, and he gives a reference of Rama and Dasharatha. And what is saying? That he final abode of all living creatures. King has reached to the final abode, means any living creature. What is the ultimatum? Ultimatum, final abode is death. Everyone who has come to this universe has to die. That's the end. And so has this king have come across this situation, and that is the king is who? The tiger king is dead. Now he will tell us how it happened. The manner of his death is a matter of extraordinary interest. And now he is trying to, writer is trying to tell us how he died, and a secret or mystery is there behind his death. He is telling that when it is can be revealed only at the end of the tale. The most fantastic aspect of his demise was that as soon as he was born, astrologers have foretold one day the tiger would actually have king, tiger king would actually have to die. So they are very, as per the royal custom, or normally in many of the families it happens, as a newborn baby comes to the world, the astrologers are brought, and then how his birth would be, how his life would be, all these things are. So similarly here also astrologers were called, and what did they say? That the king will die, or the child will die. The child will grow up to become the warrior of the heroes. And see, and what else did these astrologers say? That this child will be a very powerful person. He will be a hero. He will be the champion's best one, champions. But their bit, then what did that happen? Before they were telling all these things, they swallowed, they bit their lips. They were afraid that did not have the courage to say the fact before the king. Then what did happen? When compelled, they were forced to say, they became nervous, bit their lips, and they did not say. So they tiger king's father, he asked him to not hide anything but reveal whatever they have come to know about the child. And what did he say? The child was born under the star will one day have to meet his death. saying the star, you know, star and horoscope and all. So he's saying the moment or the star in which this child is born, he has to die one day. And all of a sudden, what happened? A miracle. While the astrologer was staying on this thing, a miracle took place. And what happened? Everyone was astonished, surprised to see from that phrase emerged from the lips of the 10-year-old Jilani, 10-day-old Jilani, Jang Jang Bahadur, oh wise prophet. Did you understand it? So what happened? As the astrologer was saying all these things, then all of a sudden a miracle took place. And that small 10-day child, he spoke up and said, oh prophets. Okay. So, and at that very moment, everyone stood transfixed, surprised. They were all very shocked and they looked wildly at him. They were looking here and there. What happened? And, oh wise prophet, it was I who spoke. And then they happened to see the child. So child is saying, hey, what are you looking here and there? It is me who has spoke. And then what happened that this time there were no grounds of doubt. And the astrologers were confirmed that this child was talking. They and everywhere were surprised who had enunciated the words so clearly. Enunciated, spoke. Everyone was surprised, a 10-day-old child speaking very clearly. Then the chief astrologer, means the head of the astrologers, he took off his spectacles and gazed. Gaze means observe minutely at the child. All those who are born will one day have to die. You don't need your predictions to know that there would be some sense in it. So the child is telling what to say, that in a squeaky childlike voice, is saying that, you know, one who is born has to die every day. So what's new in your this thing? Then the chief astrologer was worried. He put his finger on the nose and he was wondering that how is it possible. Then not only that, it also raises intelligent question. Incredible, rather like the bulletins issued by the chief astrologer was worried that not is this child only talking, he is raising intelligent question. His power of intelligence is also very high, and really it is incredible, means unbelievable. And what is he comparing it with? That sometimes during war and all, bulletin board, certain news or messages are there, and hearing that, everyone doesn't believe, or it is really strange to believe that. Similarly, the words of the behavior of the child was unbelievable. The prince was born in the hour of the moon. Now, what the chief astrologer say, that the prince, that is the king Jang Jang Bahadur, he was born in that hour, and that hour was known as the bull hour. And this tiger and bull, they are worst enemies. So death will come to this child, and it will be from a tiger. This is what the secret the writer discloses about the death of the king. You may think that Crown Prince Jang Jang Bahadur was thrown into a quake when he heard the word tiger. That was exactly what did happen. As soon as he heard it pronounced, the Crown Prince gave a deep growl, terrifying words emerged from his lips. He's saying the child will become the crown, means his child will become the king. And as soon as this word came, the child started growling, let tigers beware. What did he do? He's saying that be careful. He became the king after. And then the first thing when he did after becoming a king, he said that let every tiger in this universe or in the kingdom or wherever it is, be careful. This account is only a rumored life in Pratibhapuram. But with hindsight, to be concluded, it was based on some truth. He said everyone knew this fact and it was the truth. Now let's move to the second part. Crown Prince Jang Jang Bahadur was taller and stronger. Day by day, this child grew up, he became stronger and powerful. In his childhood days also, what did he do to show his power and things? See, the writer has minutely described that he drank English milk, cow from milk from the English cow, and then he was brought up also by an English nanny. Nanny is the caretaker of who in the house. Okay. And at the same time, he was tutored in English by an Englishman, so nothing but English films. So here, the reference of English shows a royal status and things. So he's saying the milk he drank, the caretaker, the tutor, and the subject what he learned, the language he spoke, the films he saw, everything was in English. And we are told this is the time when the British rule was there. So the writer has very minutely referred it also. And it happened is that when he came for the age of 20, this boy grew up, the king, and then at the age of 20 when he came, the court of wards until then came into his hands. Okay, and then at the age of 20, as per the legal situation, he came, the power came to his hand, means he became the king. Everyone in the kingdom, now as soon as he became the king, everyone as well as the king came to know about the, what is that, a prediction that he will be killed by a king. Things went on like that, and then the, in every, there were so many innumerable, forests were there in Pratibhapuram, and tigers also were there. So Maharaja knew that you may kill even a cow in self-defense. There would certainly be no objection to killing tigers in self-defense. The Maharaja started out on tiger hunt. Maharaja also came to know about the mystery or the secret that he will be killed by a tiger. So what did he do is that because the killing of animals and things is legally not permitted. So what is he saying? That in self-defense, the cow, there is no harm or it's not a crime in killing a cow. So if a tiger also harms us, then we have to kill it in self-defense. And then he started moving on to tiger hunts. Here and there, everywhere he moved on, and what did he do? He kept on killing the tigers. And but you must be careful with the 100 tiger astrologers. And every time he killed the tiger, he used to tell the astrologer, see, this is the number, this many remaining, this and so. So astrologers say, doesn't matter, but be careful with the 100th one, because the 101 tiger will be the cause of your death. So things as well going and all. And what if the 100th tiger was also king? So here the pride and stubbornness of the king is highlighted. So the king is saying, oh, what if I succeed in killing the 100th tiger also? The astrologer, this tough, tough is what? A pony tail, pandits and things you have seen, choti, okay, that was there. And this astrologer told that I'll cut off my tuff, this choti, and then I'll stop. What he'll be doing? He will stop doing the astrologer's duty. He will tear off all the books and things if it is done so. And then from that day, what will he do? He's saying, the crop my hair and become an insurance agent. He'll stop being doing the astrologer's job and he'll become an insurance agent. Since that day, celebration time, the tigers inhabiting in Pratibhapuram. Every time, the state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. Okay, so many tigers were killed, and everywhere this killing of tigers was banned. But due to the power of this king, okay, he continued hunting the tigers, and it went on and things. Then the wealth and property would be confiscated. It's telling that if it is happening and anyone other than the, you have the power, so the king said, anyone other than me, if tries to kill the tiger or hunt the tiger, then all his property will be confiscated, means taken under control. And from since then, he started to keep killing the or going for tiger hunting. Not that he faced no dangers. There were times when the bullet missed its mark, tiger leaped upon him. Okay? So here, it was not an easy task, even though he was powerful. Okay? Or he was the Maharaja, he said, it was not an easy task. So many times, the king himself also had faced many problems. At times, he would miss the bullet, then the target would have missed, the tiger would have jumped upon him and so on. Then he is telling, another time he was in danger of losing his throne. A situation came when he was, due to this habit of his, he was about to lose the throne. Why? A high-ranking British officer came to Pratibhapuram, and he was also very fond of hunting the tigers. But then, what did he do? And fonder of being photographed. He was very fond of taking the photographs with the tigers and so on. And then, he also wished to kill the tigers in Pratibhapuram. But then, Maharaja was very firm in his decision. So what did he say? He did not give the permission, but what did he say? That you may go on a boar hunt, you may conduct the mouse hunt, you are already for a mosquito, but tiger hunt, that impossible. He did not allow even the British officer. British officer secretary then sent a word, means a message was given that Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. Maharaja could do the actual killing, what was important to the Durai was a photograph of himself. There, Durai is in Tamil language, the officials are addressed. So he's saying then as the king did not give the permission, then a message was sent from the British officials that the officer doesn't want to kill the tiger. But what is that? The tiger will be killed or hunted by the king itself. Only the officer is interested in taking what? Taking the photograph. That was permitted. And if he relented, now what would he do if other British officers turned up for tiger hunt? So, the king, no other alternatives, the Maharaja agreed, because if he doesn't do that, then what would happen? Some other officials also would turn up with this objection. Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations over this issue. Okay? And then what then? He was afraid his British officers would take the kingdom under their control and so on. So Maharaja had discussions with the Diwan and so on. And then what happened? A telegram was sent to the famous British officers company, that is British Company of Jewelers. It is there, a British company is there of jewelry shop, jewelry and all. So their message was sent, and then what he did was Maharaja do, he asked them to buy all the expensive diamond rings, whatever were there, of different designs of them. Almost some 50 rings came. After that, the Maharaja, what did he do? He, all these 50 diamonds, valuable rings, he sent to the lady of the British officers, that is Durai Sang, means the wife of this Durai or the officer. And then he said, any two you choose from it, and rest you send back. But to his surprise, what happened? The Durai Sani, she took all the jewelry or all the rings and everything, and then thanked the Maharaja. After that, a bill was sent to him, and that was 3 lakhs of rupees. Those days, 3 lakhs was a big amount. But the Maharaja was not bothered, because they, at least at the cost of 3 lakhs, he has managed to get back the kingdom. Now we move in the fourth section. Now Maharaja's hunting and things were successfully continued. The slowly and gradually the population of the tiger was also extincting, means decreasing. And then who knows whether the tigers practiced birth control or committed harakiri. Okay, saying that what would happen, the he is really extincting because the Maharaja is killing. Everyone was questioning themselves, or is it the tigers were observing the birth control? Okay, and then the Maharaja one day called for the Diwan. Okay, and what did he say? That now the 30 tigers are still remaining to be shot down, and then he's asking, brandishing his gun. Is it? He pointed out his gun, showing the gun. Shuddering at the sight. Shuddering, the Diwan was very afraid, and he cried out that, he's saying, why are you pointing the gun to me? Matter, sir, or king, majesty, I am not the tiger. So the Maharaja started laughing, saying that, I know you are not the tiger, but then you are not the Diwan Sahib. I summoned you here for a different purpose. I have not coming called you to kill you or hunt you. I have some other tasks to do. Then the babbling means you are shivering, and words were not clear. So he saying, don't talk nonsense. Why should I marry you? What I want is a tiger. So why did the king call him? He is telling that he wanted to marry. And Diwan thought that king wanted to marry him. So he saying that I have a wife and thing and all. So there's a bit messy conversation, funny talk is going on. Then he's saying that don't talk nonsense. Why should I marry you? What I want is a tiger. Saying that I don't want to marry you, but I need a tiger. How is it possible? That he say if he marries, then the ancestors' properties and things, whatever the wife will owe, will come to the command of the king, and so the king can hunt or have the authority to hunt in that kingdom or area also. So this way, he wanted to continue his habit of hunting. The Diwan followed his orders. He found the right girl. The order was followed. The right girl means the wife for the king was found out. And and then Jung Bahadur, who killed 5 or 6 tigers each time he visited his father-in-law's house. So after the marriage, he had the authority. So every time he went to the father-in-law's estate, he killed 5 or 6. And that is how 99 tiger skins were there. After killing the tiger, as per their pride, what these kings and maharaja used to do? They used to hang the skin of these tigers in their palace. So here, 99 skins were there. Maharaja's anxiety reached to a fever pitch when there remained just one. Now only one. And you remember, the astrologer had told that, remember, be careful about the 100th tiger, don't be overjoyed. So now 99 were killed, one just remaining. And then what happened? Even in the dream. And by this time, tiger farms had run dry, even his father-in-law's kingdom also. Now hardly any tiger were remaining. It became impossible. He had sent people around to see wherever the hunters were, but nowhere any tiger was located. And then he said, if he could get just one single beast, Maharaj would have no fears left. He said that Maharaja was also anxious. 99 was over, only one, and he was facing a lot of problems. He was not getting even a single. Then what happened? He was careful with the last tiger. What had the late chief astrologer said? I told you, he remembered the astrologer's word. And true enough, tiger was a savage beast after all. Okay, savages, he's saying, whatever it is, 1 or 100, tiger is a savage, harmful beast. And then everyone has to be careful. Very means careful about the thing. So the Maharaja was now, one tiger was not available. So he was in gloom, means he was very sad. And then soon, all of a sudden, everyone in the court was very tense that how to lessen the gloom of this, or sadness of this king. So all of a sudden, good news came, and everyone felt that his sadness or unhappiness would be lessened. And what was there? First ascertained that this was not the work of Kader Milan Sahib or Viraswami Nayakar, both famed for their ability to swallow ship. They saying that everyone ascertained means thought that maybe these two people, the name we are coming over here, that is Milan Sahib or Viraswami Nayakar. These two were what? They were very famous. Following the ship means very famous for stealing the ship and all. And the villagers then ran. They were confirmed that it was not the task of these two men. And then they ran to the Maharaja and told that nowadays ships are being stolen by someone, and maybe these two people are not involved, but some tiger is really there. That's the message. And then people were sent to find the wantedly, purposefully, might be the tiger is hidden somewhere, and the Maharaja's will can be fulfilled if it is found. Maharaja was equally determined. He was also very confirmed. This one tiger he will kill, and the 100 tiger hunting will be over. As days passed, Maharaja's fury and obstinacy mounted alarmingly. Many officers lost their job. He was not, message was there, but he was not getting. So slowly and gradually, as days were coming closer, fury, anger, and his stubbornness that I will do it was becoming more and more, increasing, alarmingly increasing. And the many officials lost their job for that. One day when he was in the height of anger, he called the Diwan, and then he said that, to increase the land tax of the people. The people were very dissatisfied, and they said that they too will fall a prey to the Indian National Congress. He's saying that they have to pay the tax. In that case, you may resign for your post, said the king. He's saying, if it is so, people will be dissatisfied. The Diwan is telling, we shouldn't do this. He's saying, if it is so, then you also resign. The Diwan now made a very heavy heart. He came back home. And now, when he felt life returning to him when he saw that tiger. It's a catastrophe, means a result. He said, if it is done, then if the tiger is not found, then after effect, result will be catastrophic, very dangerous. And he came home and he saw the tiger in his house. And some hope he had. Where he brought this tiger from? It was from the People's Park in Madras, and it was hidden in his house. Midnight, when everyone was asleep, the Diwan and his wife put the tiger in the car and then shovel means pushed the car there in the destination where the Maharaja was to do the hunting. As they reached to the forest, tiger was brought back and then he refused. Satyagraha means the tiger was stuck inside. He refused to come out from the car, but somehow the tiger, Diwan could bring it out. On the following day, that same day, then the message was told that the tiger is there and the Maharaja's presence and stood as if in humble supplication. Very humbly, the Diwan stood before him and said, "Sir, the 100 tiger has been found and then I have killed the tiger fell in the crumble." Maharaja immediately took the aim and then killed the, hunted the tiger, and the tiger crumbled and then he died. That was what. But see, this is not the end. I have killed the 100 tiger. He was very happy and he said, "My vow, my promise is now fulfilled." And ordinarily, tiger to be brought to the capital in grand procession. For he said, there was great joy, elation, happiness everywhere. And it was said that the 100 tiger should be brought before the Maharaja with great processions and all. But after the Maharaja left, the hunters went closer. After hunting, Maharaja went. The people who followed him, they went closer to see whether really the tiger is dead or not. And as they saw, they found the tiger rolling his eyes and in bafflement. The people were very shocked to see that. What if they come to know that the tiger just fainted, it has not died. And so what did they do? They now decided not to tell this to the Maharaja. But what did they do? One of them took the target and then they killed the tiger. Here also end is not there. So the message was passed that the tiger is dead, and the king wanted that this dead tiger should be taken in the procession. So those things were done and he was moved through the town, and then a tomb was erected and he was buried underneath that. Few days later, the king was after 100 tiger he had killed, so he was happy, and then now he is enjoying his life with the family. Now a son was born, and it was the son's birthday. So as a birthday gift, until then the Maharaja had given his entire mind over to the tiger hunting. So before the child was born, it was the child's third birthday, and it was to be wanted to it to be celebrated in a great manner, because all this time he was bothered about hunting the 100 tigers and so on. So he wanted to dedicate his time to the child. So what did he do? King was turned to attention. He wished to give him some special gift. This king wanted to give some special gift to the child. So he went to the shop and in Pratibhapuram, and what did he do? He came across a shop. Spotted means found a shop, and in that toy shop. And in that toy shop, what did he get? He found a wooden tiger in the toy shop, and he decided that this would be the perfect gift for him, the child. Then on asking the cost, the owner said it was costing actually 2 annas. But then the owner thought that for a king, or to give a king such a cheap gift, it's not fair. So instead of 2 annas, what did he say? That the cost of this wooden tiger was what? It was almost, it was 300 rupees. The king was happy. He asked him to give the thing, and he did not pay. What did he say? That it is a gift from your end to the prince. And he took the tiger, wooden tiger home. Very good. Let this be your offering to the crown on his birthday. Crown means the prince, the king. Okay? And then the king took it with him. On that day, father and son played with that tiny little wooden tiger. It was his birthday, and then we are told that the king wanted to be with the child throughout the day. So they were playing, had been carved by an unskilled carpenter. It was not the tiger, this thing, wooden tiger was not properly carved or built, and so what was there? Tiny slivers of wooden, tiny pieces were all coming out. And stood up like quills all over it. It was running, not properly, neatly cleaned or made. So, and while they were playing, it happened one of the slivers, that wooden piece, pricked in the Maharaja's hand. And what happened? But then he took it out, did not bother, did not take it seriously, and he continued playing with the prince, that is the child. And what happened next day? The wound turned up to be, if it was infection, the wound was infected, and the infection spread. Flared means spread in the whole right hand of the Maharaja. And slowly and gradually, within 4 days, what happened? Suppurated his pus and blood, and everything started spreading in the whole arm. Three famous surgeons were called from Madras, and they consulted, they saw, and then what did they decide? That operation was required. Operation was done, and then after the operation, the three surgeons said operation was successful, but they could not help out, the king is dead. In that manner, so in this manner, what happened? The 100 tiger, as per the words of the astrologer, the 100 tiger took the final revenge upon the tiger king. That is, as per the astrologer's word, or as per it was foresighted, that the king was killed by the tiger, or the cause of his death was the tiger. And this is how the story or the name given by Kalki proves to be successful and appropriate, and the astrologer's prediction came true, and as well as the king's stubbornness and pride came to a fall. So this is how at times we see people who are wealthy, who are powerful, they think that at the cost of their power, their richness, they can do anything or win the world, but it is not always so that this story proves that. Thank you for watching the video.